Hey there, my name is Charles, and this is part 4 of a series in which I'm using Unity to recreate the core system from Red Dead Redemption 2. In part 3, we finished up our implementation of the health core. In this video, we're going to use that implementation to finish off both the stamina and Deadeye cores. If you haven't already, I highly recommend watching parts 1 through 3 so it's easier to follow along. Otherwise, let's get right into it. As always, let's start off by reviewing our user stories. We'll be working on 2 this session, one for the stamina core and one for the Deadeye core. Each story is worded slightly differently, but they both cover the same high-level functionality. For the stamina core, we have, as a player who enjoys immersive games, I want Arthur's stamina core to deplete over time so that I have an incentive to make him sleep and eat. As a player who wants to focus on the story, I want Arthur's stamina ring to regenerate based on the value of his stamina core, so he can run longer without using consumables. And for the Deadeye core? As a player who enjoys immersive games, I want Arthur's Deadeye core to deplete over time, so that I have an incentive to make him eat and sleep. The Deadeye core's ring only regenerates when Arthur makes a kill outside of Deadeye mode, so we can worry about regeneration later in the production cycle when combat is implemented. For now, I'm pretty sure I know how we're going to implement this. I've done some planning ahead of time, and can see that we're going to come up against the rule of 3. 3 strikes and you refactor. The code that we wrote for the health core is more than enough to satisfy both of our user stories, so all we're going to need to do is a little bit of refactoring. Let's get started. As you can see, I've taken the liberty of adding the stamina and Deadeye cores to our scene by duplicating the health core twice and changing the icons. Each of the new cores share the exact same structure as our original one, but I haven't populated their data values yet, so let's go ahead and do that now. We'll need to create some float value assets, but looking back at the ones we created for the health core, I think we're going to need to update our naming strategy. These are a little too close to the metal. The icon value really represents the health core's value, so we can go ahead and rename it to health_core_value. The ring background value represents the health ring's capacity, so that one can be called health_ring_capacity. And finally, we can change ring value to health_ring_value. Now, let's create the corresponding float values for our new cores. We're going to end up with a total of 9 assets, and if we continue to use scriptable objects to decouple our code, then we're going to end up with a lot more than that. But I don't think that means that we should abandon this approach altogether. What I think it means is that, as we develop this application, we're going to need to think about how we can make working with this growing number of assets more manageable. That could be as simple as designing and documenting a more modular folder structure, or could be as involved as creating custom editor windows, or some other type of tooling that'll make it easier for our game designers to work. In any case, I don't think it's an issue right now, so we can wait for it to show up in our backlog before we worry about it. For now, let's add these data values to the appropriate components. Something that I want to mention here, and that I'll reiterate in my Scrum series, is that we need to focus on the value that we're providing to the customer, or in our case, the player. It's so easy to get caught up in over-architecting or over-refactoring some bit of code to get it perfect, and lose sight of the end goal, which is to release our game and provide an enjoyable experience to our players. I know a lot of my own projects have died under the crucible of my own relentless refactoring, which is why I find working with user stories so valuable. Every time I sit down to work on a project, I have a short-term goal in mind, and that short-term goal always provides a means and a path to releasing my game. All right, we're almost ready to test this baby out. But first, if you recall from the user story, the Deadeye core shouldn't be regenerating, so let's set its regeneration rate to 0. Next, let's give our new assets some meaningful values. Now we're ready to run the scene. Press play. Beautiful. So our code works and we've completed our user stories, but we aren't finished. For the sake of my future self and other developers who may have to work on this code base, we still need to refactor this code. But don't worry, it'll be a quick change. All we need to do is open up the code editor and rename the health system class. In Rider, this is as easy as highlighting the name of the class and pressing Shift and F6. Let's rename it to Core System. And we can do the same thing for the health system test class. Don't forget to update the variables too. Perfect. And as we do with all refactorings, let's run the tests. Beautiful. Now that is some clean functional code. If you're interested in checking out the code, then head on over to my Patreon page where you can download it free of charge. And if you'd like to support my channel, then please consider becoming a patron while you're there. All of my Tier 2 patrons get access to bonus content, which includes extra tests and refactored code that doesn't appear in the series. Well, that's it for part 4, and for all intents and purposes, this series. We've completed the basic functionality of the core system in Red Dead Redemption 2. If you'd like me to expand on these cores some more, then please let me know in the comments. Heck, why not let me know using a user story? Otherwise, I think we're ready to wrap this series up. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and a comment letting me know what you thought. And for more Unity videos, tutorials, and series just like this one, don't forget to subscribe with notifications on. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Thank you to all of my patrons, and a special shout out to NZ, Richard Stance, Sean Carey, Thomas, Willendingo, and Yagov.